Good afternoon. And on behalf of the University of Reading, may I welcome you to the Great Hall. Before we start the ceremony, I have a few short announcements. If you are in possession of a mobile phone, please switch it off or make it silent now, and ensure that it remains off or in silent for the duration of the ceremony. In the unlikely event that we need to evacuate the Great Hall, will you please note that there is an exit at the front of the hall on the left-hand side, and on both sides at the rear of the hall. The assembly point is the White Gates car park, which is the large car park adjacent to the Great Hall. The marshals located around the Great Hall will be on hand to direct and assist you. Should you need any assistance throughout the ceremony, please attract the attention of the graduation marshal, who should be able to help. When ascending the stage, please walk to the top of the steps in the silver line and doff your cap. Remember to wait there for a moment while your official photograph is taken. At the end of the ceremony, please make your way to the shuttle bus, which will take you to the White Man's campus where the post-ceremony celebrations will take place. And finally, please do remember to clap and celebrate each other's achievements throughout the ceremonies. Thank you. Graduates and guests, can you please stand for the procession?
Please do be seated. And it brings me huge honour to welcome you on behalf of the University of Reading to this degree ceremony and the recognition of all your hard work and the celebration of your achievements. I'm not sure if we've got any South Africans in the audience or the congregation today. No, right, that means we all of us can learn a new word. It's a Zulu greeting. But I think it perfectly reflects the tone of this ceremony and the spirit of how I intend to greet each of the graduates as they receive their degrees this afternoon. The greeting is the word sawubona, and it means that we see you, we see the whole of your person, we value you, and you are important to everyone here. It's an invitation to a deep witnessing and presence, and it invites us to explore the possibilities of helping each other. And I think it perfectly reflects the next hour of each of our lives. So I'm going to say to you, sawubona, my friends. And my name is Paul Lindley, and I'm the Chancellor of the University of Reading, and I'm the presiding officer of this congregation. Graduands, you will formally and officially be conferred your degree upon you at this ceremony. And today's graduates have been split into four processions, which will come up one group at a time. Each graduate will then be summoned individually by name to the platform by the university's orator. And acting under the authority of the university that's been vested in me, I will doff my cap over the university mace, which will formally confer your award. We'll then turn and smile to the gentleman there for a photograph, and you'll descend the steps here, go and get your certificate and return to your seats. There is one exception, and that will be for our postgraduate research students who will instead be invited to take a seat on the stage to recognise that they have achieved the same academic qualifications as the good folks behind me. So, graduands and colleagues, although this congregation is steeped in the university's history and tradition, above all, it's a joyous celebration, and we should at times forget the formality and just cheer and show our appreciation to the wonderful people coming up.
By the authority of the Council and of the Senate of the University of Reading, this congregation has been summoned for the recognition and presentation of degrees. Chancellor, I will now call upon the candidates to be presented for the conferment of degrees. Chancellor, I present to you these candidates to whom the degree of Doctor of Philosophy has been awarded.
I admit each of you to the degree of Doctor of Philosophy of this university.
Aisha Jelly.
Congratulations, Aisha.
James John Hart. Peter David Jolly. Melanie Kudrow. Mary Louise Nuboa. Chandrish Pravi. Chancellor, I present to you these candidates to whom the degree of Bachelor of Arts has been awarded.
I admit each of you to the degree of Bachelor of Arts of this university.
Ancient History. Angel Bernard Smith. Samuel Oliver Cross.
Congratulations, Samuel.
Elisa Octavia Dabon Corley.
Congratulations, Elisa.
Jack Brian Denley. Adam Christian Elosbay. Edward Newton. Thompson Ridgewell. Benjamin White.
Congratulations, Benjamin.
Ancient History and History, Joshua Heber.
Congratulations, Joshua.
Philippa Newton.
Congratulations, Philippa.
Ancient History with Placement Experience, Daisy Ellen Roth. Archaeology and History, Lele May Cole. Classical and Medieval Studies, Shay Bakken. Lyris Madeline Bridgman.
Congratulations, Lyris.
Francesca Teams.
Congratulations, Francesca.
Classical Studies, Howell Harley.
Congratulations, Howell.
Chuck Francis has been.
Congratulations, Chad.
Catherine Hookway.
Congratulations, Catherine.
Connie Ruth Hubert.
Congratulations, Connie.
Joshua Hirson.
Congratulations, Joshua.
Anna Jackson.
Congratulations, Anna.
Amelia Katie King.
Congratulations, Amelia.
Olivia Emily King.
Congratulations, Olivia.
Cordelia Rose Racer.
Congratulations, Olivia.
Tabitha Elizabeth Toy.
Congratulations, Tabitha.
Classical Studies and English Literature, Rebecca Mitch Stutbury.
Congratulations, Rebecca.
Classics, Max Hingland.
Congratulations, Max.
Phoebe Jemuna Goldsmith.
Congratulations, Phoebe.
Jenny Agnes Vaughan.
Congratulations, Phoebe.
Ethics, Value, and Philosophy, Victoria Buckley.
Congratulations, Victoria.
Ethan James Ball.
Congratulations, Ethan.
Jessica Dutch.
Congratulations, Jessica.
Neve Greens.
Congratulations, Neve.
Amira Hamad Kurezi.
Congratulations, Amira.
Catherine Reeves.
Congratulations, Catherine.
Maya Kamalita Salim. Phoebe Sandison.
Congratulations, Phoebe.
History, Alexander Michael Andinov.
Congratulations, Alexander.
Chancellor, I present to you these candidates to whom the degree of Bachelor of Arts has been awarded.
I admit each of you to the degree of Bachelor of Arts of this university.
History, Muhammad Ashraf Hashlan. Joshua Liam Parrott. Claudia Rose Bakers. Catherine Sylvia Sutherland Brett. Zoe Bronsky. Emily Rose Kane.
Congratulations, Emily Rose.
Emilia Carter.
Congratulations, Emily Rose.
Tilly Marion Coles.
Congratulations, Tilly.
Jasmine Daniela Colwell.
Congratulations, Tilly.
Ellen Field.
Congratulations, Ellen.
Finlay Fletcher. Nathan Kilfoy. Brooke Peel Hardy.
Congratulations, Brooke.
Tashana Ashanti Harris.
Congratulations, Tashana.
Chloe Hawkins.
Congratulations, Chloe.
Isabel Hay.
Congratulations, Isabel.
Harry Kegra.
Congratulations, Harry.
Oscar Elliott Real Leisinger.
Congratulations, Oscar.
Dominic Mikaliv Huner.
Congratulations, Dominic.
Jade Minkley.
Congratulations, Jade.
Robert Daniel Morrell.
Congratulations, Jade.
Toby Rosell.
Congratulations, Jade.
Archie Scobie.
Congratulations, Archie.
Anna Ski Harris.
Congratulations, Anna.
Nathan Barry Tidbury.
Congratulations, Nathan.
Nicholas Talker.
Congratulations, Nicholas.
Sarah Victoria Walker.
Congratulations, Sarah.
Holly Wapshire.
Congratulations, Holly.
Reese Philip Woodland.
Congratulations.
History and Economics, Samuel Ahmed Chamberlain.
Congratulations, Samuel.
Chancellor, I present to you these candidates to whom the degree of Bachelor of Arts has been awarded.
I admit each of you to the degree of Bachelor of Arts of this university.
History and Economics, Kid Omorojo.
Congratulations, Kid.
Matthew Andrew Wood.
Congratulations, Matthew.
History and English Literature, Jessica Campbell.
Congratulations, Jessica.
Abigail Chalmers.
Congratulations, Abigail.
Sonali Kaur Gill.
Congratulations, Sonali.
Lydia Ann Harris.
Congratulations, Lydia.
Laura Rachel Martin.
Congratulations, Lydia.
Ruth Weber.
Congratulations, Lydia.
History and International Relations, Charlotte Amelia Armitage.
Congratulations, Charlotte.
Samuel Robert Hamstrom.
Congratulations, Charlotte.
Libby Blissett. Joel Gibson.
Congratulations, Joel.
Diego Hawking.
Congratulations, Joel.
Jordan Williams.
Congratulations, Jordan.
History and Philosophy, J.C. Sims.
Congratulations, Jesse.
History and Politics, Suhila Abdullahi Asad.
Congratulations, Suhila.
Alex Callanan.
Congratulations, Alex.
Ben Stuart Alan Hannes.
Congratulations, Ben.
Alfie Jack Reeves.
Congratulations, Alfie.
Jack Geoffrey Reese Williams.
Congratulations, Jack.
History with a year abroad. Luke Lacey Park.
Congratulations, Luke.
Museum and Classical Studies. Shelley Baker.
Congratulations, Shelley.
Neve Ann Brandingham.
Congratulations, Neve.
Sowena Shenova Davidson.
Congratulations, Sowena.
Philosophy, Kano Bobcat.
Congratulations, Kano.
Jessica Brown.
Congratulations, Jessica.
Alice Kang.
Congratulations, Alice.
George Cornish.
Congratulations, George.
Imogen Grace Carley.
Congratulations, Imogen.
Gabriela Ray Exley.
Congratulations, Gabriela.
Thank you.
Chancellor, I present you these candidates to whom the degree of Bachelor of Arts has been awarded.
I admit each of you to the degree of Bachelor of Arts of this university.
Philosophy, Jordan Charles Gonzalez. Holy God. Oscar Harper. Eddie Jern. Grayson Gale Lowe.
Congratulations, Grayson.
Katie Elune McLaughlin.
Congratulations, Katie.
Jessica Pines.
Congratulations, Jessica.
Thomas Prissy Davis.
Congratulations, Thomas.
Juliet Rose Short.
Congratulations, Eva.
Anna Isabel Wood.
Congratulations, Anna.
Archie Wing.
Congratulations, Archie.
Philosophy and Classical Studies, Joseph Freeman.
Congratulations, Archie.
Roxanne Emily Ward. Philosophy and English Literature, Christopher Janiris.
Congratulations, Christopher.
Cecily Reynolds.
Congratulations, Cecily.
Philosophy and International Relations, Donna Zitzer Logan.
Congratulations, Donna.
Marcy Wallace.
Congratulations, Marcy.
Philosophy and Politics, Fariz Hal Sahib. Philosophy with a Year Abroad, Daisy Jennings.
Congratulations, Daisy.
Philosophy, Politics, and Economics, Ohoma Muhammad Idrisi Budali. Cahill Duffy. Bethan Gill. Callum Kenny. Shivani Makwana. Daniel Vlash.
Congratulations, Danny.
Philosophy, politics, and economics with placement experience. Besia, Cleopatra, Armstrong, Roosevelt.
Congratulations, Commissioner.
Chancellor, I present to you these candidates to whom the degree of Bachelor of Science has been awarded.
I admit you to the degree of Bachelor of Science of this university.
Microbiology, Joe O'Brien.
Congratulations, Joe.
Chancellor, it has been agreed that the remaining candidates be admitted in absence.
I admit each of these candidates the relevant qualification of this university.
The Reading Student Union Excellence Award Scheme is organized each year by the Student Union to recognize those staffs who have most enriched the learning experience of their students. I am delighted to say that the Reading Student Union Excellence Award winner for Teaching Excellence in the School of Humanities joins us today. I now invite Dr. Ruth Salter to come forward to receive the award from the Chancellor.
Congratulations, Ruth.
So when my alarm went off this morning, I'm sure I wasn't the only one with a nervous feeling in my stomach. Like many of you, I knew that this was a big week ahead. I kept thinking, has the preparation been perfect? Would we make a confident start? Would the weather be kind to us? Should I put on my lucky socks? Would the team put on a winning performance? And would this be the beginning of a new era for everyone whose big week this is? Yes, I'm embarrassed to say that I woke up already worrying about England's performance in their test match later this week. But today is of way more consequence for all of us. You have played your academic innings, you've taken your finals, you've been victorious, and you are already true champions. And that's why I'm so proud to be able to share part of your day with you today. And not only have you worked so hard for so many years, but you've done so in a period where a global pandemic interrupted your studies and changed everyone's lives. And for that, you're a real credit to yourselves and to your families, and I would like to lead them in congratulating you for going through that especially. But there is another group of people here, your fans amongst your family and your friends and your university colleagues, who have been with you every step of the way throughout your courses. And it's a really proud day for them too, to see you graduate today, knowing that they are a small but a vital part of your achievement. And so perhaps now is an excellent opportunity to thank them and join me in thanking them for helping you achieve what you've achieved. Thank you. And you know, I think it is that, the showing of thanks for each other and to each other, that really is the tradition that is the most important part of graduation. It's when the real beauty, I think, of today shines at its brightest. It's when we recognise that this is a shared experience. To be here, you have given and received help and love, and you've made lifelong friendships, and you've done it all together. So I know today is as much about we as it is about each of your individual eyes. And I know it represents that South African greeting I spoke about at the beginning, Sawubona, perfectly. Because when you think about it, a university isn't the buildings, beautiful as they are, nor is it the campuses, nor the knowledge, nor the degrees. It really is just people, and that's us. The graduates, the students, the staff, and the officers in this hall, that makes a university what it is. And if you look around, you'll find that you're in great company. The graduates in this hall cover many subjects, but what binds you together is a shared sense of discovery and a joy of learning and of wanting to do something today that will not only improve your lives, but improve those of others in years to come. And you may be graduating from Reading today, but don't think that you're leaving the university behind. You will be a part of the University of Reading for the rest of your lives. Not only through being part of the Alumni Association, but also as ambassadors for the values and experiences that you have shared whilst with your time here with us. And graduation is, in a way, especially for undergraduates, it's a rite of passage into an adult life. But although it's natural to look forward today, it's also natural to look back too. It is a wonderful moment to reflect on where you've come from and how far you've come. And I would encourage you to never forget what it's like to be young as you are now, or for that matter, forget your childhood. Because I believe that focusing on young people is the best way to build a secure future for everybody. After all, isn't that kind of the point of all of this? All your hard work over the last few years, this ceremony, and the months and years ahead as you forge your own lives, is it not so that you can know you can leave a handprint? You know you've been part of something bigger than just you, and to help nudge this world into a better place for the next group of young people who will be sitting in your seats in the years to come. And as you leave this great hall and this great university and continue on your own journey, please do remember to hold on to some of that youth. Keep alive that spirit of youth that saw you through your school days and your student years. You know, I try to do this every single day. My journey from sitting where you are right now, clutching my brand new degree certificate, to finding myself standing up here with grey hair, gold bling, that's been some journey. But every day of that journey, I've tried to keep my student version of myself close. And when I do look for inspiration for what to do next, I usually reflect back to my student self, in fact, to the posters that adorned the walls of my undergraduate rooms those 30 plus years ago. One of them was of my hero writer, Mark Twain. And I still look to his words today to make sense of my life journey. And I'm holding close some of his words today that he spoke to young people like you and to me at heart when he wrote, 20 years from now, you'll be more disappointed by the things that you didn't do than by the things that you did do. So throw off the bowlines, sail away from the safe harbour, catch the trade winds in your sails, explore, dream, and discover. And as you start on a journey of discovery and armed with your degree, your experiences, your potential, and the doors to the next exciting stage of your life's wide open, do nurture that youthful sense of imagination and curiosity and free thinking that I believe is the essence of you right now. And my only advice is to keep you, you. Keep you unique. Don't be somebody that isn't you just to conform. Be proud of you and pledge to always be that smart, strong, kind, curious person that you are right now. Because if you keep you, you, the rest of us can't wait to find where you take yourselves. Congratulations. Thank you. So, graduates and guests, I would now ask you all to please rise as I declare this degree congregation closed. Thank you.